Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will understanding about joints found in rocks. This topic will cover following points. What are joints? Different terminology used to define joints. How joints are formed. Classification of joints and importance of joints from engineering point of view. Now, what are joints? Joints may be defined as the fractures that divide the rocks into parts or blocks which have not been suffered any relative motion along that fracture. Means joints are divisional planes or fractures along which there has been no relative displacement. These fractures divide the rocks into parts or blocks, and unlike the faults, the parts have not suffered any movement along the fracture planes. It occurs in all types of rocks, igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic. We may find a quite large proportion of outcrop of any of these rocks practically free from joints at some places, but at other places the same type of rocks may be heavily jointed. Now, there are some terminologies used to define joints. On the basis of nature, joints may be open or closed in nature. Open joints are the joints in which blocks have been separated or opened up for a small distance. As seen in this diagram, JT1. This joint is an open joint which is opened up for a smaller depth in the rocks, and this opening is in direction at right angle to the fractured surface. This is the fractured surface and the joints will open in a direction at right angle to this fractured surface. Closed joints are the joints in which the blocks are not separated from each other. There is no such separation. This JT2 is a closed joint, but such type of joints allow the fluids to pass through the rocks. Similarly, joints may be smooth or rough on the surface, and the surface may be straight or curved in outline. In this diagram, JT3 is a smooth joint with the straight outline, while JT4 is a rough joint with curved outline. Or the joints may be small in their extension, called small joints. JT5 is a small joint, while the joints that are extending for considerable depth and thickness are called master joints. The JT6, which are extending for a considerable depth in the rocks, are called master joints. Like faults and faults, joints have dip and strike. Strike being their inclination with the horizontal and dip being the direction of intersection of joint plane with the horizontal plane. This diagram shows single joint plane striking north south and dipping 80 degree. This is the strike of a joint plane, and this angle between the horizontal plane and joint plane is called dip of the joint. Joints generally occur in a group of two or more joint planes. Joint set may be defined as a group of two or more joint surface trending in the same direction with almost same dip. In this diagram, A, B, C are joint sets where each joint set consists of two or more joint surfaces. This A, B and C are joint sets consisting of two or more joint surfaces. And the joint system is a group of two or more joint sets. Here A and C form one joint system, and BDE trending in the same direction form another joint system. Formation of joints. Like faults, joints are formed as a result of tensile stress and compressive stress. When this happens, the rock fractures in a plane parallel to maximum principal stress and perpendicular to the minimum principal stress. In this diagram, joints are developed due to compressive force, and here due to tensile forces, joints get developed in the rocks. Joints are found in all types of rocks, but in each type, reason for development of joints are different. In sedimentary rocks, especially those which are plastic in nature and rich in moisture, irregular jointing gets developed due to contraction on drying up. While in igneous rocks, which are formed by cooling and crystallization of magma, joints, especially vertical joints, get developed due to contraction or shrinkage during cooling and crystallization process. Sometimes repeated expansion and contraction due to temperature variation also results in the formation of joints in rocks. Many joint types, especially those associated with folded and faulted rocks, are related to the process of crustal disturbances. Sudden seismic shocks also causes development of joints in many rocks. Now, classification of joints. Joints are classified on the basis of special relationship, geometry, and genesis. On the basis of special relationship, joints are classified into two types, systematic joints and non-systematic joints. Systematic joints are also called regular joints. These are the joints that show distinct regularity in occurrence, which can easily be measured or mapped. This diagram shows the systematic joints. Such type of joints occur in parallel joint set that are repeated in blocks in rocks at regular intervals. Such type of joints have regularity in their development. While non-systematic joints are the joints that do not possess any regularity in their occurrence and distribution. These are non-systematic joints, which are developed irregularly in the rocks. On the basis of geometry, joints are classified into strike joints, dip joint, and oblique joints. The joints which are parallel to the strike of the rock are called strike joint. This diagram shows development of joints in a rock. This is the strike of rock, and the perpendicular to it is its dip. Joints that get developed parallel to the strike are called strike joints. These joints, which are denoted by letter S, are strike joints. While the joints that develop parallel to the dip of the rock, these joints denoted by letter D, parallel to the dip of rock, are called dip joints, while oblique joints are the joints which are neither parallel to the strike nor to the dip of the layer in which they occur. This O joint is the oblique joint. In stratified rock, some joints may develop essentially parallel to the bedding plane, and such type of joints are called bedding joints. These joints B are called bedding joints because they are developed parallel to the bedding of the rocks. These are different layers or beds of the rocks, and the joints that get developed parallel to such beds are called bedding joints. On the basis of origin, joints are classified into tension joints, shear joints, and compression joints. Joints which are developed due to tensile forces are called tension joints. And the most common location of such joints are the outer margin of crest and trough in folding. These are tension joints which are developed on the crest of the fold due to tensional forces. Shear joints are the joints that are commonly observed in the vicinity of fault planes and shear zones, where shearing stress prevails. This is fault plane, and the joints developed along such fault planes are called shear joints. Compressional joints are developed due to compressive forces, and these are mostly occurs in the compressive region of folds, like on the innermost margin of the axis of folds. These CJ are called compressional joints, which are developed due to compressive forces. Now, engineering consideration of joints. Joints affect the properties of rocks both in negative and positive manner with respect to the activities of professional civil and mining engineers. So, presence of joints in rocks have both disadvantages and advantages. Some of the disadvantages of joints in rocks are joints are important because they split the rocks into number of pieces, which in turn reduces the competency of rock mass, increases the porosity and permeability, and make rocks susceptible to decay and weathering. Joints become avenues for the leakage of water in case of reservoirs. The incompetency, leakage, and other effects introduced by joints in rocks may create foundation problems at dam sites. Joints may also cause groundwater problems in tunneling. Depending on the relation of dip of joints with reference to the surface slope, they may cause problems in laying roads and railways along hill slopes. Besides the disadvantages, there are some advantages also. These are presence of joints increases the groundwater potentiality in the rocks. Suitably spaced joints not only facilitate the quarrying process or tunneling process, but also reduces the cost by decreasing the use of explosives. So, thorough investigation of presence of joints in rocks is very necessary for arriving at safe and economic design of any civil engineering project. So, these are all about joints. Thank you very much.